Hi friends, some time ago I published a video with the process of assembling a small, autonomic inverter for contact welding of nickel plates to batteries. Today we are talking about a similar design. But this version has almost all the features of industrial welding machines and is a pocket option. The operating principle is radically different from the first version. After the publication of the first version, I was asked to make some improvements. Since then, I have already developed three versions of such devices. All three options were able to adjust the welding time and were autonomous. The first sample was built on the basis of the advanced controller CG3525 and the power transistors, that is, the inverter base. The device didn't satisfy because without an additional driver for switching the transistors, it wasn't possible to achieve big currents, but adding the driver would complicate the circuit. The second option is simpler. It is built on the basis of an ionister, but I had only one ionister at hand. I waited for the parcel with few ionisters from China for a very long time, so this project was also postponed until better times. The third version almost doesn't differ from the second one, except that the ionisters have been replaced with batteries. Here used lithium polymer accumulators with high current output. Now let's go to the project. The design of the welding machine consists of three main parts: the battery, control system, timer and power unit on four powerful field effect transistors. Timer has been built on the well-known microchip NE555, but the circuit isn't quite standard. When the button is pressed, from third pin the signal goes to the bipolar transistor. It opens and commutes the electromagnetic relay coil. The relay trips and plus from the power source goes to the gate of the field keys. They open and the current from the battery goes to the welding electrodes. As you noticed in the circuit, there are two power sources. First of powerful lithium polymer batteries and second is 9-volt battery. Secondary power supply is included for the normal operation of the timer. Voltage needs at least of 4 volts depending on the manufacturer of the chip. A secondary power source is also needed for correct operation of the field keys. At the moment of welding, the voltage on the main batteries drop heavily, and after a certain value it will not be enough to keep the FETs open, so the secondary source provides the necessary operation voltage. The welding time can be set by rotating the trimmer. The circuit is interesting because when you press the button, there is a clear time count. This time is strictly at the preset level and doesn't depend on what time you press the button and when you release it. You press the button, the pulse went, and the circuit is turned off until the next pressed. Now about the design. Batteries of 3.7 volts, two banks connected in parallel. Each battery has a capacity of 2200 mAh, and they can be discharged by currents 30 times greater than their own capacity. In our circuit, the currents are higher than acceptable, but since the circuit operates for a short time, the batteries don't heat up. As powerful FETs, I used four high-power, low-voltage IRLB4132. For a short time, each such FET is able to commute currents up to 620 amperes, and as all four keys are connected in parallel, the maximum current will be more than 2000 amperes. The PCB is designed for 5 FETs in theory. You can use more. The tracks of the PCB on which the FETs were mounted were additionally reinforced with a copper single core wire with a diameter of 2.5 mm, because the huge currents here will flow. The FETs are installed on an aluminium radiator without any insulation. A copper tape installed over the radiator, which is securely fastened to the radiator. In fact, the radiator is the common drain of all field transistors. Consequently, it is the bus to which the second electrode is screwed. I think there is no need to repeat once again that colossal currents will flow along these tracks, so they should be as thick as possible so that the system will work with minimal losses on resistance. The batteries were isolated from each other with a piece of composite material textilite. This was done for efficiently blow out air between the batteries if necessary. The clamps to which the power wires and welding electrodes screwed were bought in the construction store. This time I will not conduct full-scale tests, as even such batteries are weak. Unfortunately, we can't understand full capability of this device, but I will try to get normal batteries and show capability of this welding machine in all its glory. Friends, this construction hasn't been finished yet and there will be definitely improvements which I will show in the following videos. Then, we will talk about the battery charge circuit, the choice of components and so on. Therefore, please share this video with your friends. I hope many will like it and it will stimulate for the further development of this project. In the archive, you will find a schematic diagram of the device without PCBs, for I made them according to my criteria, and you can create yours according to your convenience. I wait for your feedbacks. Have a nice day. With you was Kasian TV. Goodbye.